Let me tell you something of our village and our people in the year of our Lord, 1774. Whoever has made a voyage up the Hudson must remember the Catskill Mountains. At the foot of these mountains lies our village, a few miles up the river from the thriving city of New York, which has mushroomed so amazingly in its 100 years of post-Stuyvesant rule under the British. In our village lives a kind but sadly bewildered and confused citizen named Rip Van Winkle.
Hello, Derek!
Still tending school?
I was about to close up for the day, Rip. And you?
Come down to the village. I've lost Wolf. He chased a rabbit out of sight and never did come back. Coming along?
Later, Rip. Thanks.
I am sort of holding school at the moment.
That, as you are aware, unless you're wearing a dunce cap in the corner, is America's best-known escapist, Rip Van Winkle. Mr. Irving has seen to it that his wife is usually to be found in close pursuit. And such is the case even now.
Rip! Rip Van Winkle!
Dame Van Winkle, a major factor in Rip's general bewilderment. I'm going down to the village now. I hope you'll care to come along. In front of our local pub, we are quite apt to find an extremely vocal group of philosophers and sages.
We're philosophers, we're sages, with the opening song required on all stages.
We're the Catskill Walter Lippmans here in session,
thinking deep and drinking deep for you.
Nothing can disturb our peace and quiet. Bow and arrow, musket shot, or riot.
We're philosophers, we're sages. We'll write columns for the press in future ages.
I'm an expert on finance and costal wages.
I shall specialize on international phases.
I'm a super brain that bursts all birthday cages.
I'll write what they really read, the comic pages.
I'm Van Hoosen.
Van Boosen.
Van Snoozen.
Van Boop.
I'm Schultz.
They'll talk of death and what's ashore. They'll talk of taxes while the world spins merrily upon its axes.
The peasants have to work from morn till sundown. We're the ones who'll see they darn well do.
Let the hewers of wood carry water.
We'll show them it's their duty and they ought to.
We're philosophers, we're sages. We'll write columns for the press and future ages.
I'm Van Hoosen.
Van Boosen.
Van Snoozen.
Van Burp.
He Schultz!
Uh-oh. Here comes more advice. My wife. I went home.
Did you see that loafer?
He was here a little while ago. He told me he was going home.
He'd better. The new preacher, Van Goodyquince, is coming to supper. He promised me he'd give him a good talk.
I can't take it, Derek. I'm off to the mountains.
Oh, Rip, not again.
That's a never-never land. Life has to be faced, Rip, and improved.
Let the windbags do the improving. It's an occupational disease.
No, Rip, you're wrong. The improving is up to you and me, to the little guys. These colonies can be turned into a great land for our children. But it won't be done by King George. It won't even be done by Ben Franklin. It's got to be done by you and me.
All right, Derek, I won't go up in the mountains. At least not far, but I can't go home tonight.
Rip?
Yes?
Promise me one thing?
Sure.
No grog.
No grog. You! Speak up, you little runt!
Easy, Hans. That wouldn't be necessary. He is the type would react easy with persuasion.
Who are you?
You mean right now?
Well, I mean whenever you have time to answer.
Nein. My meaning is your meaning, who are we right now, or who is it we ever were yet?
Well, I'm sorry, I'm a little confused. Who are you right now?
Let's see. Sometimes it is confused. I get it also. What time is it?
What time is...
Let's see it. It's the reign of Louis the 15th. That reminds me. Louis should be back with us now.
The time? It's about a quarter to the age of steam.
It's exactly 1769. So, who am I yet? Right now, I represent my compatriots in the matter of the brew. Pause it.
I know, I've heard of you. You're Hendrik Hudson's men from the Half Moon.
The villagers, they say so. Good.
And the fact is, we're the... should I tell him, man?
Oh, sure. He's just a little guy.
I don't want you to think we're boasting, man. But we're the heels of history.
Yeah, past and present.
I don't get it, but I don't like it either.
Oh, Derek!
Who's Derek?
Van Bommel from the American colonies. Another little guy. Van Bommel's a long way off now. And we're your friends, Van Winkle. Play along with us and we'll bring you sweet dreams and pitch you out the bowl.
But what are you doing here?
Well, this is a sort of a hideout.
Hideout?
Yeah, we're the gremlins.
Gremlins?
Yeah,
the gremlins out of history books.
Wait a minute. You say this is a hideout. What do you mean?
Did you ever hear of Valhalla yet?
Yes.
Well, Valhalla this isn't. For the world's hero sort of Valhalla is. We're more, how did Hans say, history's heels yet?
Yeah, vacation and between jobs.
And this place has everything got. Equitable climate, baths from hot springs, recreation.
Yeah, good bowling, fresh thunderbolts.
And most important, a view of everything happening in the entire world yet. Look, New York, London, Asia.
Hey, I'm beginning to believe you boys. Are you really big shots out of history books?
Yeah, that's us, the tough guys.
Oh, not all tough. I've been quite refined in many of my incarnations.
Okay. He's the refined type. Machiavelli, he was.
Fact is, I've only just returned from a most interesting assignment.
Fritz was British this time, but they worked on the little guys in Bengal. Show them, Fritz.
By all means, rather. Hip, hip, live Avenger, old thing. Black hole of Calcutta, you know?
I must be getting pretty drunk. I swear he just turned into a redcoat. I don't get it.
Brother, what have we been telling you? Name any of the heels. That's us. Name a tough one. Any tough one, and that's me.
A tough one? King George.
A tough one, I say. I see a really tough one.
Attila?
Attila, he says. The there's one was me. Professor, would you oblige for the little guy?
Attila called the Hun. He made the Romans run. He made his mark with method start. He didn't need no gun. But even on Attila, horns look stella. That was me.
Of Genghis Khan, whose hordes came down upon the poor plebeian European folks so pale and wan, well, shake the hand that is the hand, for Genghis Khan was me.
We're all drinking too much grog. Let's go home and call a thing a day. My legs feel like a polywag. Please go away.
You can't leave us now. We've got you in our power. You'll start to drool. Surely you'll be sleeping in an hour.
Stick around, you'll love it. Rip and Winkle, stay with me.
Rip, where have you gone? Remember, if you're wise, those evil men up in the glen are against the little guys. Don't let them use their wily ways. Bedwinkle, stay with me.
I must be leaving home. My mind is in a fog. I promised Jerry Bumble that I wouldn't hit the ground.
Then Bumble's awfully far away. Just follow, follow.
Bumble planned his bright new day. Go to sleep. No more stars.
Hello there. Remember me? Ben Bumble, the schoolmaster. I died back there somewhere, you know. The villagers saw me off with the Continental Army at the beginning of the war.
Wait a minute. Who did you say you are?
I am what I always was. Derek Van Bummel. Only in life is there change.
Where did you die?
The exact spot is immaterial. The villagers said that I died by the bridge at Concord. I'll say that I died again in the muck of a trench on Bunker Hill. Again on that third morning of Gettysburg. Again at Chateau Thierry. At Argonne.
Then you're a perpetual warrior.
No, thank God. At least, not yet. If Rip can be awakened, I'll avoid that fate.
Has Rip, the little guy, slept all this time? Why, it's 1920.
Well, yes, he's slept much of the time, though our wars have usually roused him. In fact, to amazing feats of coordinated effort. Some of our depressions have stirred him, too. Possibly he can be roused even now. If you'll excuse me, I'm on my way to make that attempt.
Who did you say you are?
A simple man, but one privileged in death to see beyond the years. I was at Philadelphia when they signed the Constitution. I crossed the Western Plains in 1,000 covered wagons. I stood with Lincoln on the platform at Gettysburg. I was with Wilson at Versailles.
All right, let's put it this way. What are you?
Now I hear I'm Uncle Sam. I'm Mr. Whiskers, the old guy with the striped pants in your morning newspaper cartoon.
Oh, you. What's up this time?
Rip, you can't relax again. You stayed awake to win the Great War. While you sleep, we're losing a piece. Come here.
Look on, America. See what you've done. In the year of our Lord, the ukulele and the fourth, 1921. Flappers, short skirts, haircut bob. Prohibition. Rule by mob.
Riot. Red gas.
Klansmen marching.
Election landslide.
Warren G. Harding. Big Bill Thompson. Al Capone. Secretary Fall. Teapot Dome. Big Bull Market.
$4 week.
You're a fashion enough to eat.
Now the market tumbles.
Wheat the buck.
It's only the farmers who are out of luck.
Here's a little guy, the common man, getting along as best he can. His jobs are fewer, things are tough, but he can still scrape up enough.
The country's gone collegiate, money comes from Pa. Football, hip flask, rah, rah, rah.
But the little guy isn't in that game. He's out of work. Since depression came, even butts are few. He lives on stew. In 1921, that's who.
Derek, I'll stay awake now, I promise.
If I could only believe that, Rip.
Listen, it's my friends, the little men.
Your friends.
I wonder what shapes they'll be in this time.
Whatever shape they're in, they're never your friends.
You'd better stay with me then.
I'm powerless, Rip. I can only fight them through you. My immortality, in fact, my very existence, vanishes when they appear. Please, Rip, stand up to them.
Wait, Derek! I need your help.
We are diplomatic boys and we love a lot of noise, but you mustn't think we mean to do you harm. Though we deal bombs and treaties, we devour bowls of Wheaties, and that's the major reason for our charm.
And though we oftentimes have friction, we've a common predilection, and on one thing we are all of us agreed.
It's our solemn bounden duty to steal any kind of booty,
such as oil or any bases that we need.
You no doubt are all agog in a sort of mental fog as to why we carry these about with us.
They're the symbols of our trade,
knowing that they may be sprayed.
The other side is not as apt to fuss.
Immortal gods of war, we are Wotan, Mott, and Thor, and we love to see the humans play their games. Once, they used just sticks and stones, even then, they piled up bones, but now, they fight with lovely, gorgeous flames.
Good boy, good boy.
Gentlemen, it's treaty signing time.
Yeah, but not here. The little guy might be watching.
Righto, rather.
What if he should see a treaty?
Yeah, then he'd know what was in them.
And then he wouldn't want him.
Yeah, then we'd be out of work.
And that's not diplomatic.
Gentlemen, quiet, please. Back to the embassy.
Derek, where did you go?
I told you, Rip, I'm powerless before such influences. The resistance must be yours. They're coming back. One blow of your strong right arm will brush them into oblivion. Please, Rip.
Hey, look! The guy woke up again.
Where did you get the silly-looking outfits?
Well, it's like this. At the moment, we're diplomats. International diplomats.
Fascinating work, really. Amusing, too, at times.
Yeah, good bowling. Fresh thunderbolts.
Yeah, well, what do you do?
Well, we,
What do you mean, what do?
Very simple, really. You see, just last week we...
You know, the guy's got a point. What do we do?
Why, sillies, we sign treaties.
That's it! We sign treaties.
Who cares about such stuff?
You know, it's funny. You folks always make me sleepy.
Yeah. Sleep is the best. Easy now. We help you. So.
La 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 la. Why?
We will isolate America from sea to sea.
We will guarantee the people white supremacy.
We will bring the country back again to normalcy.
So la 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 la. Why?
Rip, you great, stupid, well-meaning fool. Well, we're all coasting now. Through the 20s. The ballyhoo years. Does that bother you? It could be for Red Grange, Dempsey, or a matinee idol named Valentino. Hold on now, Van Winkle. Take a ride with Socks and Bonds. A ride on a dizzy market. A front seat on a rocketing, heartbreaking roller coaster. Steady, Van Winkle. We're going up, up. It's 27. It's 28. Past Lindbergh, past Peaches Browning, up, up, higher than a Wall Street broker's window. Look out, Van Winkle, we're at the peak. I thought that would wake you, but there's not much you can do about it just now. It's tough down there. Prosperity, they say, is just around the corner. There's the corner. He'll make out. He'll get along somehow through 31 and 32. It's 33 now, and new voices are heard in the world.
This great nation will endure as it has endured. We'll revive and we'll prosper. Let me assert my firm belief that the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
And in Germany, there is a new chancellor. He's speaking at this very moment in the Reichstag.
Es ist unmöglich, dass wir getrennt als frühe Staatsmann aufstehen und hören, wie hätten jemals eine Forderung an Frankreich gestellt, die zu erfüllen mit der französischen Ehre oder mit den französischen Interessen unvereinbar gewesen wäre.
Is there nothing that will keep you awake? That menacing chorus is now the rage. It's 36 and it's a hit in Austria. 37, it reaches the Saar in the Rhineland. 38 and it sounds in Munich. It's 39, it's September 2nd. That was Warsaw. That was Paris. Dunkirk. Moscow. Stalingrad. Pearl Harbor! Are you awake now, Van Winkle?
thank God. That means the end for this particular group of conquerors. Listen. It's their swan song. They're hearing it in North Africa,
Italy, France, Luzon, the Salmon.
And now, praise God, in Germany.
Easy! Well, it's as good as over.
On your feet, Rip. Your real fight is just beginning.
What do you mean we've won the war, practically? Those few Japs still resisting can't touch America.
Yes, the Japs will be taken care of. But the world's problems are just beginning. They need you down there, Van Winkle.
We've done our job. America is safe.
You think so? Listen.
Ankara, July 30th. Tension mounted in the Balkans today. Russia has made three distinct moves to extend her sphere of influence westward. Turkey is feeling pressure from the same source in the matter of the Dardanelles.
That's a long way off, Derek. It's as close as your own backyard. 12.5 minutes by rocket.
Changsheng, China. Fighting between the communist and national forces continued in the border provinces today as peace talks were broken off abruptly in Nanking.
You're getting farther and farther away. Listen, you fool.
New York. Dr. Theodore Koch, Dean of American Scientists, today declared that biological warfare must become a part of America's armament. We cannot, Dr. Koch said, permit other nations to outdistance us in this field.
Biological warfare, germicidal warfare, agricultural blight with starvation for a world. Another year and Hitler would have had them. 10 more years and 10 sovereign nations will have them. We've got to turn to the philosophers, to the teacher from Galilee, to the poet.
Those dreamers.
And men shall beat their swords into plowshares. Tennyson, the Parliament of Man. There was a dreamer who a century ago foresaw today's dreadful dilemma.
For I dipped into the future, far as human eye could see, saw a vision of the world, all the wonders that would be, heard the heavens filled with shouting, and there rained a ghastly dew from the nation's airy navies, grappling in the central blue.
Aerial warfare. This was 100 years ago, remember. The destruction of half our civilization. And finally, man's only salvation, a federation of the world.
But we're not ready for it.
Of course we're not ready for it. But there's no other way out. It's either that or extinction.
Okay, my idealist. How about the Russians?
It's our best answer to them.
Some answer.
Of course we've got to start with the democracies and let it grow into world union. Our own great hemisphere, plus Western Europe and Britain, can start an organization now which all the world will eventually plead to join. Tennyson's prophecy will come true. But shall that federation of the world come only after a new dark age?
Why, here come my friends the dwarves. They'll set me straight.
They'll set you straight. They'll lullaby you to sleep again. At least they'll try. Please, Rip, you're the American voter. Keep your eyes open.
We are legislative mentors. We're habitual dissenters with offices in Washington, D.C. And we have a lofty notion that the great Atlantic Ocean is the surest bet for saving liberty. And we hold a brief for greeting in the form of global meeting,
for that only raises taxes in the end.
Why should anyone expect us to give dough they don't respect us?
If we're tough enough, the world will be our friend.
We're the big shot hardy wheels. We train senators like seals, and we've brought along our troop to do their act. And they can juggle, they can dance, sing soprano or ail entrance any voters who are not concerned with the facts.
If they all were on our string, then our worries would take wing, and the people we could thoroughly disdain. But too many keep remote.
Oh, that's a lump within our throat.
But here are some we're sure will entertain.
The senator from the east.
In this land of milk and honey,
I represent the money that is found above the Mason-Dixon line. And I try to save my bosses from pecuniary losses by some method that I'd rather not divine.
The letter from the West.
The land is spurs and boots and sun-kissed citrus fruits. I'm on my way to Washington one day. I'm as quiet as a mouse when I'm in the upper house, speaking only when instructed what to say.
The senator from the North.
In the sprawling Middle West, isolation pays off best, so I hate the British and all foreign guys. And stand firm upon the plank, let us write no chicken plank. We will keep our dollars home if we are wise.
From the South.
I'm a julep-drinking boy, filibustering is my joy. I'm the big wind from the South.
Ooh-wee.
I campaign on catfish dinners. With the poll tax, I'm a winner. A vote don't count unless it's cast for me.
Gee, fellas, I'm glad to see you, cause I've been hearing stuff that ain't too nice. It scares me stiff. I need advice. A friend says the world is shrunk up small, but there ain't no room for hiding it all. Oh, now, that ain't right. He's crazy in the head. Oh, say it ain't so. I want to go to bed.
Well, look here, bud. Why all this ruckus? We can help you out, but we gotta have a caucus.
Because one more war means we're done for good. It'll put us right back where the caveman stood. Oh, must I stay awake for the world below?
We'll ask the boss. The answer's no. Who cares for the world and all that fuss? We're interested in the old U.S. Forget about the French, the Czech, and the Greek. Europe's always up a creek.
Now, that's just what I wanted to hear. Let's get some sleep. Oh, there's nothing to fear.
Now you're talking. Stretch out, Gus. Close your eyes and listen to us.
La, 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 bye.
We will wave the flag of sovereignty for you on high.
If it brings another war, it's just your sons who'll die.
We'll strike first another time, and so you needn't sigh.
La, 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 la.
Inhumanity to man makes countless millions mourn.
And we can't stop wars. The little men told me so.
Listen, Rip. They'll tell you that war is inevitable, that it's part of the nature of man, that the cycle is set and there's no use to fret, and each piece just a 20-year span, but they lie in their teeth. We know underneath they're just clutching at status quo. They're old men past their prime, crying peace in our time for their miserable few years to go.
Hiroshima, Nagasaki, watch the Japs go boom. San Francisco, Cincinnati, London, hear your doom.
They'll tell you that man is competitive, that he'll always fight for his tribe, and I'll say that they're right. But the meaning of fight doesn't have to include new sides.
Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Bumble thinks I'm bars. Will hold us in, he's full of gin. Wotan, Thor, and Mars.
If you happen to come from Texas, you'll be proud of that Lone Star State. But you'll save some zeal for the common weal of our nation. God, keep her great. And while you can love your country and boast you're American, you can still hold allegiance to a world and make it an Eden for man.
Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Wotan, Thor, and Mars.
the war drums beat no longer, for the battle flags were furled in the Parliament of Man, the Federation of the World. There the common sense of most did hold that fretful world in awe, and the kindly earth did prosper, lapped in universal law.
Phrase has no easy answer. The peril to our planet has been documented in chilling detail by Jonathan Schell and others, but all are vague on the solution. One point they agree on: it must be political, not military. Translated, this means some version of Tennyson's Parliament of Man. Yes, versions have been tried and found wanting. Wilson's League and our own UN have been disappointments. As Rip said, we're not ready for it. As Van Bummel answered, of course we're not ready for it, but there's no other way out. It's either that or extinction. And then he adds, Tennyson's prophecy will come true. But shall that federation of the world come only after a new dark age? We wonder. What do you think?